So now we know about the when, what, and how of adaptive design, let's look back at those suboptimal tablet UIs and see what we can do to improve them. So this Gmail-esque example previously led to uncomfortable reading experiences on widex screens. We can use the divide pattern to show message details on larger devices to make better use of the space and contain either column from becoming too wide and uncomfortable to read. Here, we're capping the list at a maximum width and then filling the remaining space with the message details. Notice that we're also using the expand pattern within the message details, where it also caps the body at a maximum width to ensure a comfortable reading by introducing margins beyond that point. This adaptation could also help with context. We can read a message within the larger context of other emails, for example, seeing if a new message comes in. If we don't have more content that we can reveal, then we can restrict the width of the surface and use generous margins to stop it from becoming unbalanced. Before, this example felt unbalanced on larger devices, leaving large areas of white space. We can apply the extend pattern and introduce this new surface to contain the form on larger screens. We center this surface and apply generous margins within it to maintain balance. In our last example, we previously had a number of issues with unbalanced layout, overly wide buttons, and poor use of imagery. When adapting to wider devices, we can set a maximum width on the buttons, and here we reflow them to the right, preventing them from reaching awkward sizes. We can also use the expand pattern on the content to center on its own surface beyond a certain width. And lastly, we switch to a more immersive image position with the content overlapping it to prevent the issues we saw before.